evening students. Today we are going to discuss 10th standard civics second lesson, central government. We already learned the first lesson for Indian constitution. So central government, in India we have two types of governments. One is a central government and state government. Who is the head of the central government? Yes, prime minister is the head of the central government, and then cabinet ministers, and here the in Tamil Nadu, that is in state government, is chief minister is the head of the state government. Yeah, now in this lesson we have only discussed central government. In the next lesson is a state government. The central government is a supreme government in our country. It is a highest government in our country. Yeah, the other states and all the subordinate government, the head of the department, head of the government is supreme government, is central government only. The headquarters of a central government, where it is located? Yeah, New Delhi only. Our constitution is a democratic form of government. In earlier lesson we learned it. So India is the largest democratic government, and the definition of democracy and who told the definition of democracy, everything we learn is the our constitution is a democratic form of government. The central government consists of the organs, the union executive, legislative and judiciary. So Indian constitution, there are the three wings. One is a executive, legislative and judiciary. The union executive consists of the president of India, and then vice president, the council of ministers headed by the prime minister, and attorney general of India. So the first one is the union consists of the president of India, the vice president, council of ministers, and so all are headed by prime minister. The legislative is known as the parliament. So where it is, laws and all making in parliament only. It consists of two houses, one is a upper house and lower house, otherwise Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. The president of India, so what are the qualification of president, and what are the functions of presidents and all, we are going to discuss. The president is a normal executive of the authority. He is the authority of our execution, and he is the first citizen of India. Who is the first citizen of India? Yeah, the president is the first citizen of India. He is the supreme commander of army forces. He can command any army forces. Appointment and the qualifications and all, he can give. Who? The president. The president is also the constitution head of our union executive. The president of India resides at Rashtrapati Bhavan in New Delhi. So the president is in stay in the Rashtrapati Bhavan. And the qualification of the election as president, what are the qualification of the president? He is a citizen of India. All the members, all president, prime minister, chief minister, everything is a citizen of India. And the age limited is at least complete 35, and he is not hold any office of profit under the union, state or local government. And these are the qualifications. The one is he is a citizen of India, and then second one is the age limitation is 35, at least completed the 35 age, and he is not holding any office profit under the union, state and local government. This is the qualification of president. And the election of president, the president is elected by an electoral college by means a single transferable vote. It's a single vote only. Once elected as a president, has to take an oath of office before the Chief Justice of India. The president is elected for the term of 5 years. What is the period of the president? It's a 5 years, and he can re-elected. He can, after the 5 years also, he can re-elected. And the powers of the president, what are the powers he have? And first one is executive power, judicial power and financial powers. First one, executive power. President appointed the prime minister and the other members of the council of ministers. He give the appointments of the prime minister and also the other members of the council. He is distributed the departments of them on the advice of the prime minister. He is a giving appointment to the other members, advice of the Prime Minister. He is responsible for making a variety of appointments. It's a wide appointments. So like that, the governors of states, all the states governors, and all the states chief ministers, and other judges of the Supreme Court, and High Court's judges, Attorney General, Auditor General, Chief Ministers, and Chief Electoral Commissioners, and other Election Commissioners, Chairman, and other member of Union Public Service, and Ambassadors, High Commissioners of other countries. So these all the giving appointment for President. And this is the function of the President. And another important function, he is the supreme commander of the defense force, that is army, navy and air forces. He is a first giving appointment and then awards to the President. All bills passed by the parliament became a law of act. So before the act is called bill, after the discussion of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, that bill is passed as an act. Only after the getting assistance of the President. So President only give the signature and approval, getting approval, then only it is called law. Money bills cannot be introduced in the parliament without his approval. He only giving approval of the money bill, then only we can applicable, this bill is only applicable in parliaments. He can even dissolve the Lok Sabha before the expiry of the term of the house. He can easily to dispose the Lok Sabha members. He nominated 12 persons who are eliminate our goods to in the literature, good in the literature, science, sports, art and social service to the Rajya Sabha. He can nominated how many members? 12 members he can nominated. That 12 members is in good in literature, art and science, social service and sports, and this and all. So who and all the very experts in this, he can appointed the 12 members. He can also nominated 2 persons by a Anglo-Indian community. So Anglo-Indian community, he can appointed the 2 members to the Lok Sabha. And previous 12 members is in the Rajya Sabha. This 2 members is elected in the Lok Sabha. And he also, the Lok Sabha, he also appointed that the community in the unequal representation in the house, 2 houses, he is a full of representations. And the next one is financial power. Money bill can be introduced in the parliament only with the prior recommendations. So his recommendations only, the his approval only, the money bill can be submitted. And annual budget presents before with the permission of the parliament. So annual budget, we can producing before that annual budget, we producing and get the permission from President. He constitute a finance commission after every 5 years or on the demand of the state to recommend the distribution of revenues between the central and state government. He is a demanding and states of, if it is any problem is happening in the natural calamities or any other problem, so the state government is asking any amount, any demands, the central government, the finance minister only sanctioning this and all. And the next one, judicial power. President power to grant pardon. Pardon means is a in Tamil we are saying no mannipu. So great pardon. And then refit and remission of the punishments. He can reducing the punishment or in the dispose the punishments and giving the great pardon also. President is not answerable of any court of law for exercise he or his power. He have a full power to operate anything, and he don't, he is not controlling about the any kind of a court. And the next one is military power. So already we saw the regarding of the army forces. The president and this declared to be the supreme commander of the defense force of our country. In the exercise of this power, the president who can declare war against the country or making peace. So he can full power to making peace or in a declare war. And the qualification and elections of the vice president. After that president, the vice president is a second important person. So the vice president occupied the second highest office. So he is appointed as a highest office in the country. He is the next rank of the president. This office is modeled on the lines of the American vice president, where it is we are following the American vice president only. So the qualification, he should be the citizen of India. He must have completed the age of 35, and then he is holding any office in the union and the state and local government. He should have the another qualification to become the member of a Rajya Sabha. And the first three one is so far same in all qualifications. And then functions of the vice president. He record the proceeding of the house. He is the head of the house. He declared the order of the house. And he decided the admissions of the resolution and questions. He can raise any ones. So easy to ask the question. So everyone is answerable to his question. And the next one is Prime Minister. The post of Prime Minister India has adopted the Westminster in England. The leaders of the majority party, Lok Sabha, is appointed by the president as a prime minister. The other ministers are appointed by the president on the advice of the prime minister. And the duties and functions of the prime minister. Prime minister is the head of the cabinet and other ministers are his colleague. The prime minister supervises the work of the various ministers. The Prime Minister acts as the link between the President and in the Council Ministers. So rest of them we can discuss in the another class. Thank you.